The Caribbean community CARICOM represents a dream from which a reality was formed and continues to evolve. A social reality for which hope may be expressed such that no doubt is left when the statement is made, all are we is one. All are we is one in this melee, a melee spawn of oppressors and oppressed, a human juxtaposition of what makes man good and evil, a juxtaposition from which variant forms of thinking, beliefs, words, dialect, actions, norms, and cultures emerged to shape what may be a people whose identity can be seen as distinctly Caribbean. All are we is one, human, a creation of the universe, a universe for the most part unknown, an unknown to which prayers go and to which the question is asked, what does it mean to be Caribbean? Hunting and gathering, the paleolithic Indian societies migrated into the region of what is now the West Indies. In time, and marking the Neolithic period of human social evolution, they grew into agrarian civilizations and were led by the sovereignty and dignity of their own ways of life. They had cultures which included institutions of politics, religion, economics, trade, and gender. They are now referred to as the indigenous peoples of the West Indies. They had conflicts amongst themselves, however, were peaceful in comparison to the barbarians who will later invade their homes, homes where they had lived for thousands of years. 15th century, God, gold, and glory, concepts from which entrenched ideologies came to embolden Europe's racist ethos, an ethos which led to the obliteration of ancient civilizations in the name of Europe's civilization, a barbarity of which the world continues to grow cognizant of today. The zeal for a god through religion, the ferocity of greed through capitalism, and the delusion of racial superiority through politics, combined with advanced technology and weapons, drove Europeans to shed the blood of innocents and to supplant his identity upon the new world. Yet, 500 years later, European descendants remain like those of other races, mulatto, Creole, mixed, and acculturated into Caribbean experiences. Caribbean society, a microcosm of Earth's peoples brought together more so by a fate of guile and bonded together by the shedding of human blood and dignity. The indigenous Indians, the Europeans, the Africans, the Asians, and the Americans, a cacophony of races, classes, religion, and ideologies, a tussle of prejudices and human rights softened by the sameness of our humanity over the course of 500 years, and today, all are we is one. What was it, a white revolution of capitalism or a black revolt of the human spirit? Was it civilization on the advance or a stripping away of human grace? Was it brutality or beauty which brought us CARICOM today? What's more, can we reinforce peaceful prosperity as a region, a prosperous peace for which we pray as individuals and societies through our religions of voodoo, Christianity, Islam, Hinduism, and Rastafarianism? Maybe all our way is one because all our prayers for social satisfaction go to the same God. 500 years of West Indian evolution through cultural angst, xenophobia maybe, yet given way to miscegenation and many tones of skin color. Ethnic indifference, maybe, yet the syncretism of religion, language, folklore, music, dance, dress, and food. Oligarchies, perhaps, yet swayed by social unrest leading to the sharing of education, economic principles, social class, and political will. Which perspective defines Caribbean identity? Is it creolization according to Edward Camus Braffitt, or pluralism according to Michael Garfield Smith? Maybe it's because ultimately, man's gregarious nature will not be denied, and so, all are we is one.